Your happiest spring starts with Lowe's. And Lowe's has everything your lawn needs to look good. Like Scott's Triple Action Lawn Fertilizer, starting at $29.98. And save $30 on the Craftsman 20-volt trimmer blower combo kit. Was $129, now only $99. Create a season full of green and get the most out of spring. Lowe's, home to any budget, home to any possibility. Selection varies by location. While supplies last, about 317 through 323. U.S. only. Scott's offer excludes Alaska and Hawaii.
Every morning is a new opportunity to take in the news of the day and the challenges of life and try to make sense of it all. Right now, we've got a show that tackles the topics and asks what you think. So get ready to start your day with a bold look at history as it happens. Let's learn, live, and sometimes laugh together. It's the Mark Davis Show on 660 AM, The Answer.
And a good morning and a Merry Christmas, everybody. Our final hour together of the day, our final hour together of the year on this Tuesday, the 21st day of December 2021. When I walked into this building in June of 2012, and then just 6 months later got to do our very first Christmas show, brought Ethan in to share that portion of the Christmas story from the book of Luke that Linus does, and he sounded like Linus at the time. He no longer does at 18. You'll hear him just after the bottom of the hour. And ordinarily, I have been surrounded by the warmth, quite literally, since it's a small room, of eight or nine of our church friends at Fellowship gathering in with their voices and their gifts and their instruments and doing a sort of a live Christmas concert here in the building. Last year, that obviously could not happen. This year, it was just logistically difficult. Next year, Christmas 22, it is in the books. We are going to do it. I am confident of this. And speaking of confidence in what has been another crazy year, less crazy than 2020, one can argue, but who knows what lies ahead. We've tried to claw back and fight back and reclaim our lives, as the daily prayer that we do each morning suggests. So as we wrap up, as I did last year, I said, you know what, even though we can't do the live in-studio thing, there are some things I want to share musically and some moments I want to share, and so we are going to do that, and we're going to start with my church family that I'm enormously proud to be a part of at Fellowship, and at Fellowship Creative and Derek Bonneau and those folks and the folks who usually come. I just want to send out some love to Ed and Lisa Young and for just another year in their house of worship, but of particular value. When they come in, they always say, what's one that you want us to do? What's one that you want us to do? And I always tell them that the take that they put on O Holy Night, which has always been one of my favorite carols, is something very, very special. So from the studio, Fellowship Creative and O Holy Night.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till He appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Hear the
Every time somebody does "O Holy Night," I'm reminded of why it probably occupies the biggest part of my Christmas heart. And I'll tell you another version of it. That's the folks at Fellowship Creative. Thank you, guys. Another version that is front of mind for me, and many of you probably have just seen this in the last few days. I don't know. There's parts of the show that change, and there are other parts that don't. I hope this is one that doesn't. They have a quartet of guys who do, in the midst of, I mean, literal Broadway quality stuff for The Gift of Christmas at Prestonwood. I think that run has come and gone this year. If you ever have a chance to consume that, run. It is, run toward it, because it is something. But the four guys who they have doing a kind of a four-part harmony on O Holy Night, whew, that is something. So you have songs, Christmas songs, that are obviously deeply religious, as is the meaning of the holiday. And there are plenty of other Christmas songs that are not, you know, exactly about Christ particularly, but are about the season and yada yada. And I have plenty of room in my head and my heart for those. And one of my favorites of those is "I'll Be Home for Christmas." So let me pause, come back. One of the great voices of our time does a version of that on an album of his that, because of when it was recorded, contains a piece of content at the end that is pertinent to what was going on in the news and in our world. And so I'll run that one for you next. Ethan coming up with a Christmas story right after the 9:30 news break. So a lot of these are going to be things that you have heard. Speaking of harmonies, if you're a fan of multi-part harmonies, you will enjoy the Silent Night version, Lisa's favorite, that we will do at the very, very end of the program. And I can't get out of here without some more Francesca Battistelli. So there's that coming up as well. But there's one tune that maybe you've never heard in your life, that when I saw it on an album that this band put out, I didn't even know it was, even when I saw the title of it, I didn't know that it was a Christmas song. But I soon learned, and that'll be a part of our broadcast as well. It is 9:19. Merry Christmas. Mark Davis, 660 AM, The Answer. So in a season where we talk about gifts from God, the voice God gave to Josh Groban, wow, I don't know how that happened. Well, actually, I do know how that happens, but it's a remarkable thing. And he puts out an album in 2007 called Noel. And the version of "I'll Be Home for Christmas" contains the imagery and voices of people who were steeped in our deployment in Iraq and Afghanistan at the time. We were already becoming war weary, and you know, service in a war zone is hard enough, and it was becoming controversial and just all kinds of just angst and negativity, etc. But at the Christmas season, this particular version that year, 2007, of I'll Be Home for Christmas. Now, Josh Groban doing I'll Be Home for Christmas in and of itself has value. But when you put together a production like this, it becomes extra special.
This is Captain Patrick Hogan, and I want to wish a very Merry Christmas to my family in Tennessee and to my beautiful girlfriend in California. I miss you all, and I'll be home soon.
My name is Specialist Brooke Frisk, and I'm in Baghdad, Iraq. I would like to wish all my family and friends in Georgia and Wisconsin a very Merry Christmas. I'm really going to miss spending the holidays.
I'll see you guys real soon. Love you guys. Bye.
I am dreaming tonight of a place I love even more than I usually do. And although I know it's a long road back, I promise you mistletoe and presents on the tree. Christmas Eve will find you where the love light gleams. If only in my dream.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Colonel Philip Stagg. I'd like to wish my family and friends back in Richmond, Virginia, a very Merry Christmas.
Young, and I want to send out a Merry Christmas.
I'd like to wish my family a very Merry Christmas in St. Louis, Missouri, especially my daughter Madison, who will be 4 this Christmas. I'm going to miss opening up presents with her and watching her face and seeing her face on Christmas morning and watching her, you know, experience all the new experiences that Christmas brings.
Christmas Eve will find me where the love light gleams. I'll be home for Christmas before me. If only in my dream.
I just pray every night that God take care of you and the family, and also for all the soldiers, safe return.
Hi, Daddy. Mommy, Bella, and I are wrapping presents to put under the tree, and we saved one especially for you. We miss you a lot, and we hope that you can come home soon.
Merry Christmas.
Man, it kills me even when I know it's coming. Golly. Whew, I need to warn myself. Josh Groban, and I'll Be Home for Christmas from Noel. All right, let's do bottom of the hour news with Gordon when we come back. Every year for a decade, Ethan doing the Christmas story with his ever-deepening voice, the 2021 version, the version shared by Linus from that stage in Charlie Brown Christmas. And he has a word or two for all of you in view of the prayers and the wishes for his healing from his ever-continuing orthopedic adventures. He's got a word for you as well. So my boy is next. It's 9:30. Here's Gordon.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem.
That was back in the day. That was early in our relationship here together at 6:60 a.m. The Answer. And what we have now is an opportunity to revisit. And so what a real, real pleasure it is. And I listen, it's not, as I've said 100 times, exactly what we envisioned. It is last year, of course, it was impossible to do. And this year, it's the miracle of tape again. We recorded this yesterday. Last year, I took my phone to him and we recorded it in several takes. This year, he's running quite the little recording studio upstairs. And what he did was recorded this for all of you and for me to use here. And so here is this year's version.
Hello everyone, this is Ethan Davis. First off, I just wanted to say thank you so much for all the kind wishes and prayers for me and my recovery. It really does mean a lot to me and my family. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem. And so it was, that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were, in the same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men.
We love that boy, that young man. For those unfamiliar, the recovery, which continues apace, skateboard mishap every bit of 2 years ago. Had some healing happen there, and then some other things that didn't exactly happen the right way, and had to have some surgery, and oh boy, he's only been off the crutches and the cane for just a couple months. Still doing physical therapy, but is walking on his own, doing great, and just one of the great, great pieces of gratitude that we have for this year gone by is his healing. And just so much of the love and support that you guys have shown. I as he just said, as he ably put it, we can't tell you what that means to us. So, Sawyer Brown, wonderful sort of mid-level country act. And there's been something that they did some years ago on an album of theirs, and they don't billboard it as like, hey, here's a Christmas record we did, or a Christmas song. It kind of sneaks up on you. It's a story of a man so devoted to a woman that she is pregnant and delivering a child that's not his, but he's on board anyway because he's going to love her and love this baby, and they presumably are going to go live a life. But then you realize, wait a minute. It's a particular scenario being described in this tune, and this is just a favorite of mine. And so in the midst of an hour where I'm playing a lot of songs that you have heard, probably a lot of times, but just by very special, special people, here's one that I wanted to make sure we did this Christmas. Sawyer Brown and It Wasn't His Child.
He was her man, she was his wife. Late one winter night, he knelt by her as she gave birth. But it wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. Yet still he took him as his own. And as he watched him grow, it brought him joy. He loved that boy. But it wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. But like a father, he was strong and kind and good. And I believe he did his best. Well, it wasn't easy for him, but he did all he could. The son was different from the rest. It wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. And when the boy became a man, he took his father's hand, and soon the world would all know why. It wasn't his child. It wasn't his child. And like his father, he was strong and kind and good. And I believe he did his best. Well, it wasn't easy for him, but he did all he could. He grew up with his hands in wood. And he died with his hands in wood. He was God's child. He was God's child. He was her man, she was his wife. Late one winter night, he knelt by her as she gave birth. But it wasn't his child. He was God's child.
He grew up with his hands in wood, a reference to his carpenter's profession, died with his hands in wood. Reference to the crucifixion. That is some songwriting, man. Sawyer Brown, if you want to go find that, that is on their 1988 album, Wide Open. Alrighty, I'm going to go ahead and get our final break in right now and come back with one of my favorite artists, just sort of as the bumper tune in. And then I opened with my favorite Christmas carol, O Holy Night. My bride, my wonderful wife Lisa, has a favorite, and it's probably some of y'all's as well. But there's a version of it that has become one of my favorites, and that's going to take us out for the day and out for the year. Merry Christmas. Loving this hour. Loving being with you. Mark Davis, back in a moment. Love Me, the Francesca Battistelli Christmas album.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
My discovery of Francesca Battistelli, which is just fun to say, stems from my good friends down the hall, the KLTY effect. When you're down the hall from them, you are going to discover some Christian artists. Well, here are some artists that you know well. So if I want to finish up with Lisa's favorite tune for Christmas, Silent Night, you can't do better than this. It is from Kelly Clarkson's 2013 special called A Cautionary Christmas Music Tale. And she brings in Trisha Yearwood and then Reba McEntire. So eventually you've got three-part harmonies going on Silent Night. It is a remarkable thing. These ladies are a force of nature, and I cannot think of a better way to conclude.
Oh.
Man, any one of the three of them would be quite the experience. Kelly Clarkson and Trisha Yearwood and Reba McEntire and Silent Night from Kelly's 2013 Christmas special. So, with that, time for us to head on out for the year. For producer Rhonda K. Moreland, at producer Rhonda K. on Twitter, R-O-N-D-A, capital K, thank you for another magnificent year. The adventures we'll have in 22. With Mr. Matt at the technical controls, we couldn't be in better hands. And with Gordon Griffin's newscast, you are well informed. And I am well blessed to have been in your company. Merry Christmas. God bless. See you on the 4th of January. Have the best Christmas ever. God bless you all and see you in 22.